treasurer's report.
Yeah, we have our treasurer's report for January and February of this year.
I guess, you know, the first couple of months of a year, there's not a whole lot to look at. We're not comparing, we made a decision not to compare 07 to 06 just because what happened in 06 in January, 07 in January, it doesn't really matter. Our business kind of doesn't go month by month, it's more by project.
In fact, the audit was done a lot earlier this year. Gives us clear numbers going a lot earlier in the year. So the first quarter, once the first quarter is over, we'll get a pretty good picture of where we stand. Got a clean budget and we're up to date, so we're in pretty good shape.
And we also have the opportunity to give all the adjustments from Frank's office to Sam so that these numbers are starting off with all the corrected adjustment numbers for January, which is terrific too, because you're starting off knowing where you were, Sam's numbers and Frank's numbers all aligning. Report and the state controller's report, which you can do at the end of next month, and you'll be getting some talk about merging the two together so that people only have to file one report. None of that has happened yet. So for now, what we're required to do is to meet the deadline of submitting this next week to Albany for the ABO and to send it in whatever form you want, pretty much is what they told us. So we just went through, these are the nine, so there's nine sections to it. The operations and accomplishments section, it really just runs through the deals that we closed this year for the most part. I mean, it talks about some, in here it talks about, you know, people being hired in the office and some controls that we put in terms of the accounting and trying to get to budgeting done better and all of that. But for the most part, it just runs through the projects that were closed in those six. The next two sections, two and three, you already saw as part of the annual audit. They're just pieces of the annual audit, the revenue and expenses and the assets and liabilities. That's sections two and three. The bond schedule is actually also in the audit. That's already in, that's in the audit as well. So those three sections, two, three, four, come pretty much straight out of the annual audit and then get put into this report. There's a compensation schedule that's requested, so that's in there. Six is projects undertaken, which, you know, after several phone calls and not really knowing exactly, I don't think, what they want, we decided what that meant was we were going to tell them the projects that were induced during the year. So that's what this is. It was hard to, you know, I don't think they are real clear exactly about what they want. So we had some conversations with that office, and this is pretty much what we agreed that we would send them, so that's what it is. It's just an outline of the projects that we were actually induced by the board during the year, not the closed, but were induced. Seven is a real property report. These are properties that we actually hold in title. We did, so I think we reported on this earlier in the year, but we had done a title search just to make sure we knew exactly what was being held in title by the IDA in terms of the world out there. And so we just aligned that and made sure that we knew where all those properties were. They're listed on here. In the way that they wanted them, basically the first section is the section that the IDA intends to dispose of. Okay, and those are really all the properties that have to do with the Ridge Hill project. So it's really only three properties, but when you list them out, the way you get them in the title search, it looks like a lot, but it's really the three properties. The rest of the section two, those are our projects that we're holding in title, and then the third thing is they ask, or what they ask is, what did you dispose of in 06, and we didn't dispose of anything, so there's nothing in there. Eight is, they wanted the code of ethics, which is included in here. This was adopted in July of 06 by the board. And number nine, we didn't get it done yet, because we just didn't get it done. So this is not the number nine, section number nine of the assessment of internal controls. Frank's office got a draft of it to us last night at like 7 o'clock, but we didn't get a chance to look at it or do anything with it, so it's not included in here. We're just going to proceed to send this report up without that. We tell them, they said that a lot of the IDAs when we were at the training in January were saying we can't get the audit done by the March and get to the state, this and that. They said, send us what you have. By the end of March, send us what you have. So we've got a lot of it done, almost everything done except for that one piece. So,
I think the recommendation would be to approve the report as is, understanding that it is incomplete at the moment, missing the one piece at the end, which is the assessment of internal controls. Approve that, get it sent in so the submission is timely by March 31st, I believe it's due.